Welcome to this guide where I'm going to show you how to upgrade from Windows 7 to Windows 10 without losing your data for free. And if you get any value from this video, please give it a like and subscribe to the channel. But to get into the guide, before you can upgrade Windows 7 to Windows 10, there are a few prerequisites that you need to check first. One quick disclaimer I just want to give before we start with this guide is that Microsoft recently announced that you won't be able to upgrade for free to Windows 10 from Windows 7 or 8 anymore. And this post was made in September of 2023, but I'm recording this guide in October of 2023 and it's still working, but it might stop working in the future. So if this guide works for you, please drop a comment down below saying if it worked for you or not, and also just mention the date that you performed the upgrade on. The first one being, your copy of Windows 7 must be activated. If it's not activated and you try and run the Windows 10 setup file, you'll be prompted to enter a valid product key because your Windows 7 isn't activated. So step number one is to make sure that your Windows 7 is activated. And you can check if your Windows 7 is activated by clicking on the Start button, then right-clicking on Computer, and then clicking on Properties. And then here, scroll all the way down until you get to the Windows Activation section. And here you'll see whether Windows is activated or not. The second thing you need to check is if you have Service Pack 1 installed, and you can do that on the same system page by scrolling up. And here in the Windows edition, it should say Windows 7 and then the version, and below it, it should say Service Pack 1. On this copy of Windows 7, I don't have Service Pack 1 installed yet, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that and show you how to do it. To download and install Service Pack 1 for Windows 7, you need to visit this webpage, and I'll have this webpage linked along with any other webpages and resources that I use in my written guide on my website, which will be one of the links in this video's description. So you can go ahead and get all of the resources that I use in this video in my written guide. But once you're on this webpage, before you choose one of these options, go back to the system page, and here where it says system type, you need to check if you have 64-bit or 32-bit version of Windows installed. And then when you come back to the Service Pack 1 webpage, if you have a 64-bit version of Windows 7 installed like I do, you'll need to select this option which says x64. And if you have a 32-bit version of Windows installed, you'll need to choose the normal Windows 7 Service Pack 1 option. We won't be using the third option as that's for Windows Server and not Windows 7. So I'm going to go ahead and download the Windows 7 Service Pack 1 for 64-bit systems. And to do that, just click on this download button. And when this next window opens up, you can just choose the .exe file and then click on that. And that'll start downloading the Windows 7 Service Pack 1 .exe installer file. And we'll just need to wait for this to complete and then we can run it and install Service Pack 1. Once the download is finished, don't just click on it to run it. Open the file in your downloads folder, and then once you have the file in your downloads folder, right click on it and then click on Run as Administrator. And then next you'll see this screen that says Install Windows 7 Service Pack 1, and you can click on Next. And then make sure to save all your work and close any programs, as your computer will restart automatically. And you need to make sure that this checkbox is ticked, and then you can go ahead and click on Install. And then the Windows 7 Service Pack 1 installation will start, and we'll need to wait for this to finish before you can continue with the guide. Once your computer has finished restarting, you'll see that Windows 7 Service Pack 1 is now installed, and you can go ahead and click on Close to close this window. Now in step number 3, you'll need to download and install the default secure protocols Microsoft EasyFix, and you can get it by going to this webpage, which again I'll have linked in my written guide. And once you've downloaded the EasyFix, just go ahead and click on it to open the file. If you do get any prompts, just click on OK, click on Run, then just click on I agree, then click on Next, and wait for it to install this EasyFix. And once it's finished, you'll see that it says all done, and you can go ahead and click on close. Next, you need to download and install the TLS 1.1 and 1.2 Windows update, and you can get the update by going to this webpage. And then once you're here, you want to look for the Windows 7 versions, and again you'll need to select either the 64-bit or 32-bit version depending on what you have installed on your system. I'll go ahead and download the 64-bit version by clicking on the download button here. And then I'll just click on this file to start the download. Then I'll just close this and go to my downloads and then click on the downloaded file to run it. You'll be prompted if you want to install this Windows update. Just click on Yes, and then the update will start installing. Once it's finished, you'll need to restart your computer, so just go ahead and click on Restart Now. Now, once your computer has restarted and you've successfully installed the TLS update, you can go ahead and download 7-Zip or any other file extraction software if you don't have any installed on your system. I'm going to download 7-Zip from this webpage, and I'll download the 64-bit version. Then just click on the downloaded file to install it. Click on Run, then click on Install, and then click on Close. Next, you'll need to download the Windows 10 ISO file. Now, to download the Windows 10 ISO file, you'll need to download the Windows 10 Media Creation Tool, and you can download it from this website. But on Windows 7, if you download the Media Creation Tool and you run that Media Creation Tool on your system by clicking on Run, you might get an error like I do here. And even if you go ahead and you right-click on that file and run it as administrator, it still doesn't work and you're stuck with this error. Now, everything we did up until this point by installing this EasyFix and the Windows update was supposed to prevent this from happening, but unfortunately it's still happening on my system. If the Media Creation Tool is working on your system, you can go ahead and use it to download the Windows 10 ISO file, and I'll link a guide on the screen showing you how to do that using the Media Creation Tool. But for this guide, I'm going to download the Windows 10 ISO file from Microsoft, but I'm going to skip the Media Creation Tool completely. So to do that, we'll need to download Google Chrome, and you can download Google Chrome from this webpage, and it has to be Google Chrome, as the steps I'm going to show you are going to be specific to Google Chrome. So just go ahead and run the Chrome setup file, and then click on Run, so it can start the Chrome installation. Once the installation is complete, just click on Close and close your other browser. If you are already using Chrome, you can just go ahead and follow the next steps I'm going to show in this guide. So open Google Chrome, and then go to the Windows 10 download page. Now, once you're on this page, you'll see that there's no way that you can download the ISO file right here. You have to use the Media Creation Tool. But to skip that, go to these three little dots, then click on that, then go to More Tools, and then go to Developer Tools. Now, once the Developer Tools are open here on the right, go ahead and click on these three little dots, then go to More Tools, and then go to Network Conditions. Now here at the bottom, you'll see Network Conditions, and you need to scroll down here, and here where it says User Agent, you need to uncheck this box. Then here where it says Custom, click on this drop-down menu, and change this to BlackBerry BB10. And once you've done that, you can go ahead and reload this page. Now, once the page is reloaded, you'll see this message that says you've been rooted to this page because the operating system you're using won't support the Windows 10 Media Creation Tool. Now, once you see that, just scroll all the way down until you get to this option where it says Windows 10 Update version 22H2. And here you can click on Select Edition and then Windows 10 Multi-Edition ISO. Then click on Confirm. Next, select your product language. And this is very important, as it's going to determine if you'll be able to keep all of your files and apps during the Windows 10 upgrade. So if you click on this drop-down menu, you can choose a language here. For English, there are two versions. There's a US version and an international version. Basically, if you live in Britain or EU, you'll probably be using the English international version. But if you don't know what to choose here, just select one of them and then download it. And in the next steps, you're going to see if you'll be able to keep your files and apps if you continue with the upgrade. And if you can't keep your files and apps, just come back to this step and then download the other ISO file, and then you should be able to keep your files and apps. I'm going to go ahead and select the English US version because that's what I have installed on my computer. Then click on Confirm. And then here you'll be able to download the 64-bit version or the 32-bit version of the Windows 10 ISO file. I have 64-bit installed, so I'll click on 64-bit download, and then the Windows 10 ISO file will start downloading. And we'll just need to wait for this to finish before we can continue with the guide. Now, once the ISO file is finished downloading, you can go ahead and click on Show in Folder to show it in folder. And to open this ISO file, we'll need to use file extraction software. So you can go ahead and right click on it, and then you'll see the 7-zip option here if you downloaded 7-zip like I did earlier in this video. And then you can choose this option that says Extract To, and then this file name. And then it's going to extract the Windows 10 installation files to that folder. So we'll just need to wait for this to finish. Once the file extraction is finished, you can go ahead and look for that folder inside of the folder where you downloaded the ISO file to. And here I have this Windows 10 folder. So if I open that, I find this setup application. And now to start the Windows 10 installation, select this file, then right click on it, and then click on Run as Administrator. And then the Windows 10 setup wizard will launch. On this screen, click on this option that says Change how Windows setup downloads updates, and then click on Not right now, and also make sure this box is unchecked down here, then click on Next. It'll do some checks on your PC. Next, you'll see this screen where you'll need to accept the terms. You can just go ahead and click on Accept, and it'll do some more checks on your computer. Now, during these checks that the Windows 10 setup runs on your computer, you might be prompted to uninstall incompatible software that you currently have installed on Windows 7, and you'll need to uninstall those programs before you can continue with the upgrade to Windows 10. But it's really straightforward. You should see a button to uninstall the software inside of this Windows 10 setup screen. Now, once it's finished checking your PC, you'll see this screen which says ready to install, and it'll install Windows 10, and you'll be able to keep your personal files and apps. If you want to change what to keep, you can click on this option that says change what to keep, and then you can keep your personal files and apps, your personal files only, or you can keep nothing, which basically means your computer will be formatted and Windows 10 will be installed in the process. But I'll keep this on keep personal files and apps, because I do have some files saved on this computer that I want to keep and apps that I still want to use on Windows 10. Now, like I explained earlier, if you don't have this option to keep your personal files and apps, it means you didn't select the correct language when you were downloading the Windows 10 ISO file. So go back to that step and choose another language when downloading the Windows 10 ISO file, and then you'll be able to keep your personal files and apps. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Next. And now, once you're ready to install, just go ahead and click on Install, and then the Windows 10 installation will start. Now, typically this will take around 1 to 2 hours, depending on if you have Windows installed on an SSD or a hard drive. So at this point, you can just leave the computer to do its thing and install Windows 10. And when you get back, you should have Windows 10 installed on your computer. Now, as you can see here, I finally reached the desktop on Windows 10. And I still have access to all of my files and apps that I had on Windows 7. Now from here, right click on the Start button, then click on Settings, then click on Update and Security, and then you can go ahead and check for updates if it's not already installing updates. So you can go ahead and install all of the latest updates for Windows 10 and any drivers that it might find. And at the end of this video, I'll link some more videos that'll show you how to properly update your drivers on Windows 10. But next, here on the left, go to Activation, and then just check if your edition of Windows is activated. As you can see, mine is activated with a digital license, which means my Windows 7 license was converted to Windows 10. But that's been my guide on how to upgrade from Windows 7 to Windows 10 without losing any data for free. And I'll link some more useful guides on the screen now, one of them being how to update from Windows 10 to Windows 11 on unsupported hardware. And if this guide helped you out, please like the video and subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next one.